from realwebsitehints.com, and in this video, I want to share a trick that I learned for picking great website colors even if you're not a designer. Now, I ran into this problem when I was doing my review of the Divi 2 theme, and if you're interested in watching that review, I've got a link to it here in the bottom, and there'll be another link to it at the end of this video. But the Divi theme, I thought was pretty cool, and what's great about it is that you get some excellent control over colors. I'm just going to show you real quick the dashboard for the colors. Here you can see you can pick, you know, all of these main colors. You can pick the main font color, the link color, the background color, and the accent color. And when I first started building my test site, you know, I just kind of started picking colors willy-nilly. And then I thought to myself, hang on a second, there's got to be a better way of doing this. So I did some research online, and I found two great tools that will help you make excellent color palettes, and one of them even gives you a nice cheat sheet so you know exactly what the colors on your website are. So the first thing that I did was look at the logo that I created for this fictitious website. And I wasn't actually paying that much attention to the colors I was using. I was just sort of like, oh, this kind of looks cool and kind of looks video game-y. And so in order to figure out what this color was so I could use the complementary color, or at least I thought I wanted to use the complementary color to this background of the logo, I used the digital color meter that's part of Mac. All you got to do is just search for digital color meter, and then it pops up. And then make sure it's an sRGB that seems to be the most accurate. And then, you know, you just hover over the color that you're looking for. I'm sure there's something equivalent to the digital color meter for Windows. I'm not sure what it is, though. But here we go. We've got the color that we're looking for. So it's red 255, green 55, and blue 0. So then what we need to do is we need to convert that to the hex color code, which is used by HTML and CSS. So in order to do that, I went to another website, Adobe Color. And this website is actually one of the tools you can use, and it's actually a tool that designers use for picking their colors. And if you go to Explore and then click on Most Popular here, you can get a bunch of colors that I assume were created by professional designers. So this is one way you can cheat. You can just, you know, rip off the color schemes here if you've got, you know, no starting point at all. But what I did is I went to their color picker here, and then I just wanted to convert the 255, what was it, 55, 0 to get the hex code. So then I copied this code here, and then I went to this other site, which actually gives you a really cool cheat sheet of the colors, and it's called Paleton, and it's paleton.com. The link for both of those sites will be in the description below. And then what I did is I typed in that color code that I got from the Adobe Color site. I clicked OK. And so here we go, and I've got it set to the triad color. There's four different color palettes that are typically used by designers. There's monochromatic, which is just shades of the same color. There's adjacent colors, so which the colors nearby. And then there's the triad colors, so you get, you know, three colors, so one color. So this is the main color that we picked, and then two colors from opposite sides of the color wheel. And then there's sort of the spread out colors, or the tetrad color, one adjacent color, and then two from the opposite sides of the color wheel. I went with the triad color, and then I decided, you know, I thought maybe I wanted to have the complementary color, so you can actually turn on the complementary color here. And I kind of decided that maybe the complementary color, these greens, not really what I was looking for. So then I decided to go with the opposite sort of color that I liked the most that automatically came up. And so I picked this color here. If you want to apply this as the base color, just click Apply Base Color. And there we go. Now I've got some colors, and these are actually the colors, or very close to the colors, that I wound up using on the test site. And what's great about this website is that you also get these monochromatic sections. So if you're building something like a sales page, or buttons like I built on my website, like this button here, where I used those monochromatic color sections to sort of keep all of these colors unified and keep it within this color palette that I created. And the other cool thing about this website here is that you've got a couple of options to sort of view what these colors look like. So you've got the examples button down here, and this is the one I like the best, is the city glitters. It sort of feels like it gives you a good idea of how the colors might look sort of scattered around your website. There's a bunch of other different ones. I'm not as big of a fan of those. I feel like this gave me the understanding of how the colors were going to blend together the best. But then you can also sort of go ahead and download your cheat sheet of what all of the hex colors are, so you don't have to write them down. So if you click on color tables down here, you get the color tables, and then if you click as HTML, right here, we get all the colors, and this is the cheat sheet that I used for picking all of the colors on the test website that I built, and it worked fantastic. And I just saved it as a PDF, and then I had a cheat sheet I could go back to, and I could get the hex code for any place on the theme where I needed to add a color, just decided which color I wanted it to be, and then I could always use these consistent hex codes. The other main thing I learned about color from doing a little bit of research and reading online was that you basically want to have four main colors, and you don't really want to extend beyond that. Sort of the fewer colors it has, it seems like generally the more sophisticated the design will look like. And gray, black, and white don't count as colors, so you can use those sort of as much as you want on your website. So there you go, quick tip on how to create a color palette for your website.